Oh yeah. Turn me up some. It feels so good to be back on camera. Come on, y'all out there right now. If you know the song and you in your car, you at work, sing this shit. Let's go. Yeah. She said,
you ain't no good.
No good.
But you feel so good. We're gonna rap.
Come on. It's a party right now.
But I gotta leave you alone.
Yes, sir. Gotta leave him alone. Welcome back, everybody. This is She and I. I am your host, B-Love. And like always, I have my very special host with me.
India Marie.
India Marie and B-Love, the husband and wife duo you didn't know you need. But you got us and we are here to stay. This is the best thing to happen on a Tuesday, but damn it, since Monday, guess what I'm about to do? I don't gotta tell you if you listen to the pod every damn week. India, it feels so good to be back on camera. Let me adjust my mic.
What are you talking about? We skip what, 1 week?
Yeah, I be feeling, I need the vibe. I didn't even listen.
Like we skipped a month. It was 1 week.
It was 1 week. Video. However, I didn't even post on Instagram. Like, I fell off, man. I fell off this week, but I'll be back tomorrow. I'll be back. You'll see me. I'm going to post on my page, BLove1911. I'm going to post on She and I Podcast on Instagram. I'm also going to post everywhere posting can be. Facebook, Twitter, TikTok. I might post up at your mama house. You never know about me. Just be on the lookout. India. I said I'm going to start doing it a little bit different. Tell the people where you at in the vibes.
Where they can find me. Yeah. India.Marie on Instagram.
Need a beverage.
I feel like I would usually have an update, but I don't have an update right now of nothing. I'm just kind of in limbo right now.
I don't know why you're in limbo. You didn't even tell me why you were in limbo. We'll talk about it off the mic if you would like to. I was thinking about asking you about that the other day. I forgot.
Well, so, I mean, as of right now, I still have plans on doing another event.
Big time event. Real big.
But last year, I just had way more help. Mm-hmm. The times are different this year. And if you got some free time, I have one girl who is interested in helping me, but I'm looking for one more person. So if you have some free time and you got a little bit of event experience.
A little bit. We need a lot. Don't even play yourself and say, well, I'm thinking about doing it.
I said a little bit because I can't necessarily pay you right now. It's more of an internship.
But guess what, though? If the event blow up and make a lot of money, I'm going to pay you. Listen, right now, I tell you what. If somebody out there listening to the mic right now, I mean, listening to the podcast right now, and you got some event planning experience and you want to come help my homegirl out right here, hit me up. You know what I mean? Hit us up. I got some money for you. Shit, listen. See how much money I got in my wallet right now, man. Hold up. I'm looking in my wallet. If y'all ain't on. Come on, man. Come on, man. What's up? Hit me up.
You are annoying. But you,
like, what's up? Look, what's up, man? What's up?
Oh my God.
What's up? I'm just saying, if you need some money, come holler at us. We employ everybody, all right?
I mean, we do usually pay people that help us out, but I just, if you're interested, let me know.
If y'all wondering how much money I just threw out and you're not watching the video,
$33.
It's $33. That's all I got for you. Anyway. But I personally am hiring somebody, so that's a whole nother story for another day that I might talk about one of these days. I'm going to talk about it today, matter of fact, a little bit. However, India, tell the people, not tell the people, but how was your week?
The week has been good. Congratulations to the Littlejohns.
This past weekend,
we celebrated Chantel and Otis at their wedding. It was beautiful.
Guess what I did today?
Honestly, like, all of these new age weddings are just making me want to do it all over again. But vow renewal. We got 3 years before we're at year 10.
Ooh. Lord, but you know what? I'll be honest with you. It really hasn't been that tough of a struggle. The only years of struggle, like real, real, real work, I would say the first year, year one, and what was last year, year 5 or 6? What would you call year? I know we're going into year seven. So what you call so last five. Year, year six or year five? I get confused.
Five.
Year five and year one were by far the hardest years.
So no, I would say year one and yeah. then years five and six.
What you mean? Like right now we've been good. I've been knocking that thing down.
No.
What you mean?
We're great right now.
I've been smashing.
But part of year six though.
What you talking about?
Part of year six. We came into year six a hot mess.
It's June, right?
Yeah. That's what I'm saying.
So it ain't half. You feel me? June is half. Like I feel
my
like
anniversary
May.
Was in November.
So I feel like April, May, June, we've been fine.
April.
Second
exactly,
quarter.
Exactly.
First
exactly.
or first, so it's not
so
half.
Half of year six. November, December, January, February, March. We were still struggling.
I'm talking about calendar year, but she's talking about
I'm
actual
saying,
year. I
so
got
I'm
you.
I'm talking
my
about
bad.
Like wedding year. So year yeah. one, all of five.
All of five.
Half of six.
Five was a shit show. I'm talking about
so we're
boy.
Finishing off six. We'll be in year seven in November.
Yeah, yeah.
So
I gotta
I think
say
if you make it to
fast.
10 years, that deserves a huge celebration.
I don't know. Like, would you want to do something like a vow renewal, like a big vow renewal
no,
or something like
no.
small and quaint?
I want to either go to Italy. And that's why I said we could even save Greece for then, too.
Yeah.
So either Italy or Greece. And I want to do a very small vow renewal with just like 30 people.
Okay. All right. I'm down.
That's it. This isn't like a, because like all of our family and extended friends and I like, they've already seen us get married once. Mm-hmm. So we don't need to do it again with them twice. And mm-hmm. a lot of our family, I feel like is older. And so I don't feel like at this age, they're probably not even willing to travel that far anyway.
She just trying to go on a vacation. That's all she really
no,
wants.
No, I'm saying close friends, your mom.
Yeah.
My parents.
Yeah. At this point,
and that's
real.
It. Like, and that's not to say like not including like the whole family, but I literally just want it to be small. It can even be 20 people, but something very, very small. If for whatever reason we can't make it that far, we can go to Mexico.
We can make it that far because we got something cooking, so we can make it that far for sure. All right, but give it up one more time, man, for the Littlejohns. Their wedding was phenomenal, like
beautiful,
picturesque. Got flowers hanging down. They both look good. Otis had his beard
man.
Immaculately shine. Chantel had the dope ass headpiece. It was a vibe.
Tiffany
Elliott Events. Give it up one time, Jafet.
That girl be doing the damn thing. Jafet be doing the damn thing.
It's
but
just a good damn time, man.
Yeah, congratulations to the Littlejohns.
Tell y'all something.
Wishing you many, many, many years of marital bliss and good sex.
Yes. Something I've learned. You got to keep going.
Go ahead. Because
I'm about to get somewhere. I'm about to go somewhere. Matter of fact.
No, I was actually just about. We can circle back. Go.
The
during the week, we got deep. Chill. Let's talk on the podcast.
Nah, this is something. This is somewhere I wanted to get to.
Okay.
Something I wanted to say. I've noticed two things about my wife that come with time, right? When you're married, you don't learn everything up front. Some things you learn with time. And this has been one of those times that I witnessed a pattern throughout our relationship. India is her true and authentic self when she goes on vacation and when she goes to a wedding. Those two times, I can count on her being a hell of a good time. Now, listen, before I go any further, on the flip side of that, right? One shot can lead from having an amazing night to me having to almost witness her throwing up. So, I teeter a fine line between, man, I'm about to get me some great butt, and man, I'm about to be cleaning up throw up. So, it's a fine line,
you
but
have
I
literally
have
never
noticed.
Had to clean up. Okay, maybe my 21st birthday.
I got a picture of you curled up in my phone right now in a ball. You want me to show the people?
No,
you're
but you
naked.
Didn't have to clean up the throw up, though.
I didn't, but boy. Boy, I had to clean you up.
Oh, that was probably 25th birthday.
That was your 25th. You had a... She's laying in the ball with a shower cap on, butt naked, in the middle of the floor on a pillow. So what you talking about? But So I appreciate everybody who has a wedding and invites us. I can't wait for it. Let me tell you something, man. Kayla, Ophelia, Amber, shit, anyone of, like, if you guys get married anytime, I know, like, I'm going to teeter on a throw-up side. But I say all that to say this.
Honestly.
When we go on vacation and when she leaves a wedding and she's not too drunk, your boy be loved about to turn up, if you know what I mean.
I don't even know what you're talking about because I don't even drink like that anymore. Mm-hmm. And now I don't even be hungover because I just know how to drink. If I know I'm about to be drinking, I drink so much water the day before and the day of.
Yeah.
And I drink expensive alcohol now. Back in the day, I was drinking very cheap alcohol.
You're drinking Otaka. Now she's drinking shelf.
I only drink expensive alcohol now. But I really don't drink like that. I'm a social drinker. Okay. It's probably because I'm a little bit introverted. And yeah, I know that are. If I'm around a lot of people, like if I take a shot.
Can you tell the people what you were looking for?
We'll warm up a little bit.
Boy. Shout out. I don't know if I can say it. I don't want to say a name. Shout out to the homegirl. And you know who I'm talking about. For providing my wife with a little bit of, how do I say this? Medicinal.
Shut up, Barrett. You talking too much.
Okay, my bad. She knows somebody else's wife. Big up to them, man. A great couple. But she put India on some things, Tiva, that she shouldn't probably, that now increases India's good time. So whenever India goes out, she goes to a wedding, she goes on vacation, it's almost like a thing.
Telling my secret.
Y'all got their tea? Anybody got their tea? I need it.
Boy, I'm looking for it. It does enhance the vibes.
I can tell you that for sure, though.
If I am smoking, that's how you are with Red Bull.
Come on, man. So
that's worse.
I'm drinking coffee right now, too.
That is worse. What are we talking about
cold
here?
Cold brew.
Weed.
Oat milk.
Red Bull. Weed. Red Bull. It's literally not the same. And that what you're drinking is far more harmful to your body.
That's why I drink Bang. It's all natural now. You feel me? Got to make sure I'm a pillar of health. You understand me? Because when I meant, never mind. But I did want to say so. Thank you and congratulations again to Chantel and Otis. And y'all provided me with the vibe. So I have to return the favor and provide you with nothing but more and more life and more blessings. Everything looked great. And I know that every time you go to a wedding and on vacation. I talked about that, right?
Nope. You really need to chill because it depends on who it is. I've never acted like that at none of your friends' weddings.
If it's my friend's wedding, shame. Like, if it's not a mutual friend and if it's somebody that I brought to the table and I brought into our lives, Indy's going to be an introverted self at the wedding. Like, give me some glamour. So I just want some wine. I don't even need no weed tonight. I need a little bit of wine tonight. And I ain't going to drink that much. And Barrett, you ready to go? I ain't trying to step in the name of love. I'm trying to step out. I'm ready to go. I'm like, God bless. If it was my friend or your friend's wedding, I'm going to be in here dropping
but
it low, picking
wedding,
it up. We danced
like
all damn night, man.
We literally danced from the time we walked in there to the time we left. My homies was there. I got a group message. Me and Barry, we got a group message. The group is called Bunch of Married Niggas, and it's four couples. And three of the four couples was at this wedding. It was a good time.
Let me tell y'all something about, like, my friends. They know how to have a good time, and another thing about my friends that are married is nobody is afraid or nervous to show their wife, significant other, that they love them. I'm talking about, man, everybody would dance no A woman. Grabbing butt, bending her over, pushing her head down, popping that thing. Like we were back in 2008. They were probably in high school. But everybody was having a good time. And like I told y'all last week, man, don't be too cool to tell your wife you love her, and don't be too cool to dance on your wife and kiss your wife in the mouth and on you grab a cheek at events, man. It's just your woman. Don't be, you're with her for a reason. Hit the button. I'm just saying, man, some people get too cool. Like, you come into a big event and it's a lot of people there, and all
they
of a sudden,
a bunch of cool
you get
people.
Too cool to give some affection. Not me. And that's what I like about Otis and Chantel, too, right?
Like,
I'm gonna say this.
What?
My boy, you can tell everything was like real from the moment they walked down the aisle, even to the reception. My man, And it's same for Chantel, but my man Otis was like, man, like just enthralled with his woman. You know what I'm saying? Enthralled with his wife. You could just tell, like, it was probably one of the happiest days of his. I'm speaking for him, but I can just, you saw the vibes, right? And I feel like that resonated throughout the crowd, and they jumped on India, and then we got home, she jumped on me. So, you know, that's how and it so, is.
What I will say this, I think that one of, because all of our friends are getting married later in life. Yeah. It's like late 20s, early 30s that I, like, well, I'll say mostly my friends. And I think the benefit to that is, well, a lot of your friends have already been married. Yeah, that's true. But because you're older than I am.
I think
the benefit to doing that is you truly being able to make your own decisions and have things exactly the way you want to have them. So, like at these weddings, I literally noticed the bride and groom on the dance floor the whole night, throwing ass, having a good ass time.
They got grown friends who do grown things.
They don't, and you know, they're not inviting people that they don't want to be there, like, or none of that. But I feel like when you get married younger, it's just you have that influence of your family, and you like, well, what if they don't like this? And da 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 da. I think as you get older, it's just like, I don't care. Like,
you're trying to have a big ass party when you're young, but you're trying to appease your family at the same time.
And it just don't work.
Yeah.
It just don't work.
What they say, what God said, you can't serve two masters.
The past two weddings that we've been to, granted, you know, COVID could have played a part in the guest list, but they were way, like, significantly smaller than the wedding that we had.
We had such a big wedding.
And we don't talk to half of the people that was at our wedding anymore. Yeah, right. So it's just kind of like, it's really not worth it. So that's why I think, like, that's definitely the benefit to getting married when you're older. Because the older you get, the less people you know.
And then look, too, if you're not married right now and you may be a little bit older, don't even worry about it. Like, take your time. Still fill everything out, man. Your 30s ain't nothing but 20s with money. That's what they told me.
Yeah.
So, there you go. I had to listen. I took a deep pause right there. And you probably wondered, what was that awkward silence about? Well, don't worry about it. Blake is down there with his cousin, and I'm concerned. I get concerned, all right? Speaking of, Indy's always talked about, man, I want two kids. I want two kids. I want two kids. She got her wish this week with her niece coming in town, right? So Indy's niece has been here. Our niece has been here for the last week.
My brother's daughter.
Been here for the past week.
Yes.
How has that made you feel about having two children?
I still 100% want two kids. Damn. So this is what I'll say. I have been dog-ass tired. But I think it's because...
I haven't.
It's just like...
Energizer.
I think it...
See what I'm saying? And just as we talked, he came in. So yeah, as y'all just heard, Blake walked in. But I was asking you, how has it been? And you were telling me how tired you've been.
Yeah, I've been tired. Like, mm-hmm. They just be going, and it's funny because they actually act like siblings.
Yes.
They bicker like siblings. Like, Blake is only 3, but he's constantly trying to boss Elise. And Elise don't know what to do. She's 9. And she's like, Blake won't leave me alone. And I was just like...
Two different personalities, too.
What is even happening here?
Yeah.
But they, I think that they really have been having a good time.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And it was the other night. So Barrett is like... I was talking to my mom and I told her... Barrett is a phenomenal dad. If
Ooh, hold on.
For whatever reason, whatever the many reasons was that I chose him as my husband, the fact that he's such an amazing father, like, I wanted him to be an amazing father, but you don't know that until you're actually a father. I chose the right one for that.
Mm.
So it was the other night. Thank we were you. All... You're welcome. So we were all sitting in Blake's room, and Barrett was helping Elise read a book, and he was so patient with her and so loving with her. And I just remember being little and learning, and you know, a lot of us grew up with impatient parents when it came to classroom kind of stuff, and it's just parents just lack patience in general. But you were so patient with her, and it just kind of blew my mind, because obviously, I mean, you're super patient with Blake too.
Yeah.
And so we were all just sitting in there, and I was like, I could get used to this. Like, I could,
I could not.
I could do, you know, the family of four. Mm-mm. I could totally do that. So I'm tired, and like I was sitting there, they was doing something earlier today. I was like, damn, y'all getting on my nerves.
You know what's funny? Go ahead.
But like, her being here has not deterred me from wanting a second kid.
Damn it.
It's made me want a second one even more.
Oh my God, Jesus, what did I do? Sometimes you do your job too damn well, and then it backfires on you, right? Like, I know people at work, they'll ask for help, like knowing that they can probably already do the job or do the thing that you told them to do, but they'll ask, so they'll mess it up. A lot of people do it with clothes. So they'll do laundry one time and then mess it up, and you never ask them to do it again. They'll go mess all your whites up, mixing whites with the reds. They blend everything, and you get pissed off.
Yeah.
You say, don't do it again. I guess I did it too good of a job. Now it's like, well, damn, I see he can handle it. So let's put it on him for sure.
You did.
Don't put that on me.
You did. So you, okay, so her being here, you still do not want a second kid.
I'm just cool, you know. The thing about kids is that are not yours, you can give them back. You know what I mean? I can't give Blake back. It's mine. But this one, I can give her back. It's my girl. You know, it's my dog. But I can still give her back.
I just think it's fun.
Yeah, I mean, it has been fun. Yeah, I can record the podcast if she keep him occupied. But obviously not, because you just heard him come up here. And the thing about Blake, I think he would do a great job being a older sibling too. I think he'll do a good job.
His little ass is bossy.
Yeah.
Oh, he is so bossy.
Easy for him.
But he's just, I mean, because some people are like, well, you know, it's okay to be the only kid, but her being here has really showed me the benefit of them not being the only child.
You can play, you can go.
Elise is an only child, and Blake is an only child, and it has been a little bit of a struggle for both of them, because they both like to have their own way.
Yeah,
which is fine. Blake has, I mean, Elise has been the only child for 9 years. Mm-hmm. Blake has been the only child for 3. So I definitely see the benefit of having more than one.
Listen, by the time, speaking of vacations, by the time you leave, by the time she leaves, you will need a vacation.
Yeah.
Now, more so me than her, but whatever. Speaking of vacation, still brings me something I want to talk about. I saw this post on Instagram. Shout out to the homegirl Aisha. She sent it to me, matter of fact. It says, Vacationships. These couples only meet up on the road. Let me explain what it is. Vacationship is where a couple or two people meet only on vacation. They don't talk to each other before, a little bit before, but after, they're friends, they're cordial. But when they go out of town, they go together and they do the vacation together. Question for you real fast. If we were single, could you do and handle a vacationship?
Oh, absolutely.
So you can just go out of town with a guy.
Mm-hmm.
Have like a week, 10-day vacation, 3-day vacation.
Mm-hmm.
After you guys leave, you go your separate ways. And, you know, you correspond throughout. But, like, mostly it's kind of friends. Mm-hmm. But when you are on vacation, you are a couple. I'm talking about you doing everything couples do.
So, I'm down for that if the guy lives in another city. Because, you know, sometimes...
I like me. Go ahead.
Sometimes you meet... Like, I've met guys, you know...
Hold on. What you mean you met guys?
Well, before you, obviously. But I've met guys before in other cities. And I'm like, wow. Like, I would really get to... Like, I would like to get to know this guy. But it didn't make sense. Because they lived in a whole completely different city. So...
Mm-hmm. That's a good point.
You know, if I'm single in my city and you single in your city, but I do want to go on a vacation, I don't necessarily want to go alone, and you're with it too, then yeah, let's do it.
I like your thinking. So I read that over and over again. I'm like, could I do it? I could for sure do it. But My only, like, I probably got a few stipulations. One of my biggest ones is, if we're doing this, we both have to agree not to catch feelings after the trip. So what's going to happen is, if we agree to this and we're going on all these lavish vacations and we're doing this, that, and the third, we have to agree upon after the vacation, we're going to go back to our regular friendship, and then we go on vacations. We're in a vacation ship.
Well, see, I'm okay if we I'm okay if the vacation ship turns into something else, right?
Like, let it do organically, though, as long as it's not forced, okay?
Like, if we go on this vacation together and we just so happen to vibe, like, way more than what I thought we would, then it's like, okay, you want to go on vacation again in 2 months?
But yeah, so,
you know, and then we just keep getting to know each other, and then, you know, if it comes to a point where you want to make it more than what it is, do it. If you don't, then don't. No strings attached. What I like about that is that you can go on vacation, have sex with this person, and if the sex is ass, that's it. You don't have to worry about it because
off the hook.
We're just on vacation together. I'm going back home, and that's it.
She wanted to say, and not sound crude, she wanted to say, I'm going back home and I might get me some more from somebody else who's slanging it.
Yeah, I mean,
You stopped yourself, but I know what you wanted to say. I know, like, the vibe. What you mean? I know.
Sex could be terrible and it's fine. And then what's crazy is that you can actually tell him that.
Because
it ain't supposed to be no feelings or nothing attached. Then,
well, on vacation. Only on vacation. You know what? My other thing would be, too. I didn't mean to cut you off. But on vacation, I do believe it is supposed to be feelings. It's a vacation ship. Like, y'all holding hands on the beach. You might ride a horse. Everybody know when you ride that horse in the water, y'all go together. You feel me? Like, there's no doubt about it.
Well, when you see the sunset. You can do it. And it's kind of like a...
I can show
sure
do
All good things
it.
Must come to an end.
There you go.
And this just actually, I know somebody that's going on a situation or vacation ship next month.
Shout out to that person. Who is it?
I can't say.
Damn, I want to shake their hand.
That I can't say. But what's crazy about this person is that, so I think they've dated before.
Oh, they about to go back together. They about to rekindle, restore the feeling. That's all they're about to do. That's it.
They don't stay in the same place.
But see, they don't even count because now they don't even matter, though. If you do that, the only thing that he's trying to do is get that old thing back. Now, if she's willing to go on a vacation, she wants it back, too. So they ain't really counting, though. I'm talking about if you and I were just friends.
No, because there's really no expectation. Well, right now they are friends. They just talk on the phone. They're not dating. They're not doing any of that.
Okay. All right. But they got history, though.
They do have history, but right now they're just friends. So they're going out of town together, but I don't think it's expected for it to be anything more than that once the vacation is over.
Let me tell you why you can't do that, right? When you have history with somebody and y'all go on a vacation ship, you begin to do everything that y'all used to do from the past, which is going to trigger that endorphin or that memory in the back of your mind. You're going to pull it to the frontal cortex. And you're going to be like, shit, man, I'm trying to... I can get used to this again.
But maybe it'll seal the deal. Maybe it'll bring clarity to the situation. Because maybe it'll just be like, wow, we tried it again. I just really don't like you that much anymore.
I'm not vibrating on the same frequency as you no more. I got a dip. My frequencies are off. The vibes are not there.
Yeah.
I mean,
sometimes with vacations, I'm the type of person who I could go on vacation by myself and be just fine. Like that, though. And people love a good vacation.
See, that's the thing. And
people
love
going out of town with a significant other. Or not even a significant other. I think a vacation is literally going on a vacation with somebody that you're physically attracted to. Y'all whining and dining each other, and y'all having some amazing sex the entire trip. That's like the good, nasty sex that you're just not going to have at home.
The wedding and the vacation sex is the best type of sex. Listen to me. The post-wedding and the vacation.
Not wedding night sex.
Nah.
That sex
I'm
is
not
ass.
Talking about yet. Like, nah, not all. Nah. Going to somebody else's wedding like we just did.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So, Well, it depends on the situation.
Yeah, you can get too drunk. I said that already. But you didn't do it this time. I'm just saying. Keep going.
I don't even remember what I was saying.
Now, I do know I see a lot of, not see, but I know a few people that I follow on Instagram, a few nice looking young ladies. Y'all be getting fluid out a lot. Now, I know the vibes. I know what these guys doing. Yeah. Going on these vacation ships. And I don't blame them because, you know, some of y'all are good looking. I get it. If I was single, I may toss my hat in the ring to fly Drea out.
I guess that kinda, Joy. I guess that kind of is the definition of getting flued out. Because a lot 100%. Of folks that be getting flued out, the relationships, it don't be nothing past that. Let they go you. Get flued out, have a good weekend, and that's it.
Boy, let me say something right now. Y'all girls think y'all slick too. And really don't be y'all. Let me put y'all on game. Y'all girls think y'all slick. Y'all be taking pictures, just having the guy's hand in on your shoulder, or having the guy's shoulder in the background. Like, you know, real discreet. Not showing the guy. Not showing anything that can kind of give up who the guy is. Not revealing his identity. Really, the guy is doing all the hiding. Y'all think y'all doing something, but it be us. We don't want to be in your picture as much as you don't want us to be in your picture. I'm telling you. You ain't finna blow nobody cover. They going on vacation. I'm like, man, what if I want to call Drea right now? I'm like, hey.
That's what I don't understand.
I'm going to L.A.
Guys will spend all this money winding and dining somebody that they ain't supposed to be talking to, and you don't even want to be seen. You just want to spend all your money.
We're here for a good time, short time, not a long time. We're here for a good time, not a long time. That's what the saying is, right? I said it right the second time.
Here for a good time, not a long time.
That's what I'm saying. So why would I invest my time in trying to be all over the ground? No, I don't give a damn.
I got a friend that's in a serious relationship right now, and she just went on vacation.
She's ridiculous.
She just was like, no.
Yeah, she's just being ridiculous.
I'm like, you can totally post. I talked to her today,
and I said, why you didn't post that picture? No. Want to call her real fast?
No.
I bet you won't call her. Blow her cover. Blow her spot up. I do. Blow her spot up. I edit it out. It might be like a post-podcast thing. After we get done with the episode, y'all stick around. And if she allows us to record it, I'm going to call her up in a second. But I am going to do it. You know I am. But with all that being said, I think I can, if I were single, go on a vacation ship and have the time of my life.
And go back
with
home.
The understanding that we cannot catch feelings afterwards. And my second stipulation I didn't get to, we both have to know that when we leave, upon us departing, you can't just call me and ask me for like random favors. Like, let me borrow XYZ money. Some people that do that get too familiar.
Hey, no, I don't think so.
Let me tell you why I say that.
I don't think so.
We go on vacation, and I wind and dine you with some of these $33 I threw out. And all of a sudden, you see me whining and dining, and man, we go back home, and you be like, you know, I need help doing X, Y, Z. And if I say, no, I can't help you with it, you can't get upset with me, right?
But could a vacation ship be with just a friend? No sex attached?
Well, no, this is not what this says. But it can, most definitely. But that's not the thing that I'm talking about right now. I'm talking about going, you're single. And the only time I have a relationship is when I'm going on vacation. That's what I'm talking about. I don't know what you're talking about. But yeah, whatever. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, I did want to touch on that because the homegirl Aisha sent that to me. I said, we got to talk about this. Now, before we depart the pod and get into our favorite segments of the podcast, I have one last question that pertains to Father's Day. So Father's Day, if you don't know, is this Sunday. So all you people go out there and make sure you get your Father's Day gift. I gave a list of them, I think 2 podcasts ago. So go out there and check it out if you did. And also, listen to last week's episode. It was by far one of my favorite episodes that we've done in a long time. It was the only bad thing about it, we couldn't record it because I didn't have my camera. But anyway, now, my question. It was sent in. It says, not really sent in. It wasn't sent in, I'll be honest with you, but I saw it. But I'm going to pretend like it was sent in right now. But this one wasn't, all right? But this, I got a question. So my boyfriend has kids. None by me. It's from a young lady. My boyfriend has kids. None by me. I don't have any kids. So for this weekend, I'm sorry, it's Father's Day. And he has been asking me, what am I getting him and what are we doing for Father's Day? I went on to tell him nothing. And that Father's Day is for my dad, not my boyfriend. Am I wrong?
I don't think she's wrong.
Ooh, now if the shoe was on the other foot, go ahead, tell me why.
Because those aren't her kids and they're not married. That's her boyfriend.
Yeah.
If he's a genuinely good dad, yeah, I would say get a Father's Day card be like, you know, I see you. I do think you're an amazing dad, but I'm not going out and buying you no extravagant gift and you're just my boyfriend.
I like that.
Sorry, it's not happening.
But I do think, as a girlfriend, you have now committed. It depends on how long we've been talking right?
I mean, what's crazy is that I know somebody in that situation.
Right now?
I know a girl dating a guy who has a kid, and Mother's Day rolled around, and
she
has, you know, been involved in the kid's life over the past year, and I think he just got her a card.
Okay.
Just a Mother's Day card.
But that's pretty cool, because she's not the mom.
Exactly.
But this guy he has kids. The girl, his girlfriend, does not have any, but she's been dating him.
Yeah. No.
He's a great father. She shouldn't do anything.
Yeah, he's a great father. I'm going to get you a card.
Now, you know what's messed up about this whole thing?
And now, granted, if she has a relationship with the kids.
Okay.
What she can do... is do an art project.
I knew you about to say that. Yeah.
From the kids to him.
Personalize it.
But as far as me getting you a gift for these kids, and I'm not your wife, and I don't even see these kids, no.
Now watch this. What's messed up is, if the baby mom goes out there and gets him a nice gift, then the girlfriend gonna be all up in arms. You must be still messing around, because for her to get you something like that, it just ain't gonna be no just because. But you had to be doing a little something extra, and it's probably not even the case. But
no,
you will be so mad.
No, but here's the thing. If something ever happened to us and we divorced and we began dating other people, I think that you would always still give me something small
for Mother's Day. Blake to you before me. Yeah, that's what I would do. I'm a real player, though.
Exactly. So if the mother of his children chose to do that,
okay,
and they have that relationship to where, you know, it's just about the kids, and the mom wanted to get him a gift from the kids to him, then I think that's perfectly fine. But again, I have no commitment. I mean, other than us saying that we're boyfriend and girlfriend, I have no commitment to you, bro. Like, I love you as my boyfriend. I think you're a great dad. Here's his Father's Day card. That's it. And I think, what's wrong with him? Why is he expecting that of her?
You know, he may have put in a lot of work, and he like, man, you've seen me put in work with my kids, and he may have done a lot of stuff for her. And it's only right, if you see me doing good things and you know I'm doing a great job, he may feel like he needs to be rewarded. You know what I mean?
I understand that, but until you make me your wife,
ooh,
I'm not doing it.
Well, there you have it.
You have to have some sort of boundaries, there has to be something that distinguishes you from his girlfriend.
It's true.
And his wife.
This is true.
That's a wife thing. Only because...
or it's a baby mama thing. Like I said, if I'm India's baby dad and we're not dating, I'm going to give India a gift, but it's going to be from Blake. Vice versa. I would expect her to give me a gift, but it would be from Blake. So that's what I would expect. So that's what you should expect too.
And I think it also depends on the situation, because I'm thinking back to a previous couple that we've had on this podcast.
Mm-hmm. I was thinking about them too.
If those kids have become like your kids, like say for instance,
yes, ma'am,
you live with your boyfriend.
Okay.
And you share responsibility over watching his kids. And you know, it's a mutual agreement between all parties involved. and you have a really good relationship with these kids, that's completely different.
Then they're like yours. If you treat the kids like your own and you welcome them in, and like you said, every party knows the vibes, everybody gets a gift. Mama, stepmama, stepmama soon to be, everybody gets a gift. Stepdad, mm-hmm. stepdad soon to be, whatever. Mm-hmm. All of that. Everybody deserves a gift. So that, there it is.
Yeah.
Ooh, knock it out. Now, let me get to my favorite segment of the podcast, because these kids might come back in the room anytime.
Now, unqualified advice from B-Love and B-Love's relationship.
I got the keys, the keys, the keys. This week, B-Love's relationship is brought to you by this cold brew coffee that I'm drinking from Dunkin' Donuts. If you get one, make sure you put a little oat milk in it. Don't get no damn coffee without no oat milk. Stop drinking dairy, man. Oat milk is the way to go. Anyway, don't Ooh. Get too excited. I do like some cheese. I ain't gonna hold you. But the oat milk changes your life. I prefer oat milk over almond milk, but it's neither here nor there. Here we are, right here. Relationship, man. It's quick story that I'll tell. I've been a few places in the past week or so, right? Everywhere I've been, I've noticed the same routine when I talk to married men that own their own businesses. They all say the same thing. Man, listen, I can't do XYZ without my wife, or man, my wife helps me do XYZ, or my wife is part owner in XYZ. Got me to thinking. Everything good happens for your business when you include the input of your wife. Personally, same thing goes for me. Fellas, so my relationship is this. If you have your business and you're thinking about like, man, I don't want to include my wife because this is mine. I know a lot of us get that attitude. I had it for a while. This is mine. She doesn't need to be involved. Like, I have been carrying the torch for so long that I don't want any input from her, because then that'd be like, I'm watering. Or you might think it's going to mess up the relationship. No. It's probably going to enhance the relationship, and it's also going to enhance the family business and make a lasting legacy for your kids. Nieces, nephews, whatever the case is. I can name a few people that I know work together. Emily, Cece, mm-hmm. the guy I just bought this car from. Mm-hmm. So I'm talking about specifically me, you, whatever the case is. I know I'm missing a few people, but you guys get it. When you start including your wife in decisions you make about your business moves, treat it like a business part of relationship. And don't be scared. I made the mistake, and I'm going to still talk about this real soon, but I'm still in the middle of it. I made the mistake in making an investment. This is what we've been talking about. Here we go. Without involving India, right? The investment I thought at the time was an amazing deal. Turned out not so much. And I'll talk about it when everything's over. And I'll tell y'all kind of not exactly what happened, but I am going to tell kind of the end, the backstory a little bit. But anyway, I should have included India, but I didn't, because I thought it was, you know, couldn't miss. Looking back on it, when I told her, she was like, you thought that was a good idea? She didn't scold me. She scolded. She knew I was hurt about it, so she really didn't come down on me hard. Now, had I included her in that, in my thinking, in my thought process, she would have been there to kind of weigh the pros and the cons and help me know, Barry, this is not a bright-ass idea. Now, including her in my personal business that I established when I was 22 years old, letting her come into my fold has now opened up multiple legs of this business. And I just want to, you know, say thank you for one part. And then secondly, just advise all the fellas, man, anybody, not even men, women, dogs, cats, whatever. If you're out there right now, include your partner. Partner. Listen to that. Make everything better. That's it. That's all. Shit, I know it was. I'm on fire today. You ready? Let's hit the button.
Let her upgrade you. What would India do?
Come on. WWID. What would India do? Kick it.
My boyfriend accidentally sent me a text that was meant for another girl. Yesterday, I randomly got a text from my boyfriend of 3 years saying, I can't wait to see you naked tomorrow. The anticipation is killing me. LOL. When I asked him about it, he said it was meant for his coworker. And he told me they all had been just messing around and joking, and that it was in reference to them making fun of her, that she's going to be so drunk at a work party that she'll be taking her clothes off. He's never lied to me before, but I just think that's an extremely weird and inappropriate thing to say to a coworker. And while in a relationship, even if it's just a joke, should I be worried? Yes.
Absolutely.
Yes, you should be worried. Because here's the thing. That conversation is so inappropriate that if anybody found out about that conversation at work, it would be a huge HR issue. I'm not having those type of conversations with my coworkers playing unless I'm actually screwing my coworker. I don't want to joke about seeing, like, I'm thinking back to all the people I've worked with. Good God, I would never want to see their asses naked. So I'm not playing with you like that. I'm not.
Yeah, you're right. I'm thinking back. Nah, I don't want to see none of my coworkers today. But my God, you got to come up with a better lie than that. Next time you say, I lost something. My mind, that's what I lost. I don't know what I was thinking about sending that message to you. I was really sending it to you saying, I can't wait to see you naked tonight. The anticipation is killing me. Then you would have got that shit off. But just making up a lie about your coworker, that's not the move, all right?
This is not it. And then, how awkward is it? What if he works for the type of company where they have company events and they take their significant others? I've met several old coworkers, boyfriends, fiancés, husbands, and stuff. And so you're supposed to show up to his job after he's texted the coworker this weird ass text message? No. It's so inappropriate.
So what I want to know is if she even believes something like that.
What did she say?
Listen, if you believe that, you are naive and you deserve to be cheated on.
And I would be like, well, let me see the conversation. Pull up the text messages. And if the text messages are deleted, he's for sure lying.
Listen, man, cuz I hear straight up sent that message to the wrong person. And next time, my man, cut your phone off. Is that true? If you cut your phone off and you get ready to send a text message, like it'll disappear or something?
In the middle of his sending?
Yeah, somebody said, like, if you quickly, y'all let us know out there. Y'all out there doing dirt. If you cut your phone off, will it delete the text message before it sends? I want to know.
I don't know.
You doing dirt? You probably almost made a mistake and sent me something meant for one of the homegirls. I know you did.
Recently?
Nah, I hope not.
Oh.
You gotta watch out, man. You be trying to send a workout plan to somebody on Instagram and I send it to you. I'm like, wrong person. Y'all That's be sending posts.
I'm so scared. Like, I be double checking, triple checking. Make sure I'm sending this shit to the right person.
I ain't gonna lie. Okay, cool. I sounded out before I hit send. You ain't finna catch me out here with my drawers down. No, indeed. India, we got these kids. So tell the people where they can find you.
India.Marie on Instagram.
That is. And you know where you can find your boy, BLove1911, on all social platforms. Be sure to follow She and I Podcast on Instagram. Leave us a message at SheandIPodcast@gmail.com. Looking forward to hearing from you, man. I'm trying to get these guests on. It's been a lot. It's been busy. I got a few lined up. I just got to schedule them in. So it's kind of my fault. I got two lined up for show. Just got to schedule them. So in the meantime, in between time, we coming back with guests. Y'all hold tight. But like always, it's been real. It's been fun. She,
I, out.